As I mentioned earlier in this chapter, surface controllers are MVC controllers that interact with the front-end rendering of your Umbraco page. In this video, we'll be building our first surface controller, which will contain two separate methods. The first method we will use to render out the partial view, which we created in the previous video. And the second method is the one that will handle our form data submissions. So what should happen to the data submitted via the form we have on our website? All right, I say we jump right into it. So this is where we left off in the previous video. We just finished creating our article form partial view and got rid of the static HTML on our form template. Now this means that there currently is no form on the submission form page on our website, at least until we render in our partial view from here. Now, in order to do that, we need a method to help us out. And this is where the surface controller comes in. So let's create one. In the Solution Explorer, scroll a bit up here to find the controllers folder. Right click and choose Add Controller. We'll choose an empty MVC5 controller. Select Add. All controllers need to have a name ending in controller. So let's call our controller for article form controller, as it really is a controller for our article form. As you can see, the controller will already have one method, an index method. We'll update that one in a bit. First though, we need to make sure that the article form controller here inherits from the Umbraco Web MVC Surface Controller class. Currently, it's inheriting from controller, which comes from the System Web MVC class. It's the one that you can also see up here. All right, so we will add surface to this one, and we'll need to add a using statement for the Umbraco Web MVC as well. Now, let's get started on our first method here. Instead of index, we want to call it render, as it will be used to render our article form partial view. Now, in this method, the first thing we want to do is to create a new instance of our article model. So we'll create a new variable, call it article model. And this will be a new article model. There we go. Ah, and we need to make sure that we're using our custom models on this project. So we need to add a using statement for surface controller chapter models. And there we go. All right, that was the model. Now every method needs to have a return value. In the case with our render method here, we want the return value to be our partial view. So we'll replace the current one here with partial view. And in the parentheses, we'll add first the name of our partial view, which was article form. And then we'll need to tell it which model to use. And here we'll use the variable we just created, the article model. All right. And there we have it. That was the first method that will let us render out our partial view. So for the second method in our controller, let's jump down a few lines here. And we'll need another public action result method here. And this one we will call submit, as it will eventually trigger once someone hits the submit button on our form. All right, so this method needs to take a parameter, which should be an object of our view model type. And this is article model. All right, this will now get passed from our view to our method here. All right, that's our second method. Now we want to control exactly where this method can be accessed from. And for that, we're going to be adding some attributes to the method. So that'll be up here above the method. The first one we'll add is HTTP post This will ensure that the method can only be accessed on the post HTTP method. All right, we also want to make sure that the method is only available when using an Umbraco form. For that, we'll add the validate Umbraco form route string. And there we go. These attributes will ensure that we have full control over when this method can be used. Okay, so now I mentioned before that all controller methods need a return value, and so does this one. That's why it currently has a red line under our method name here. So we'll be adding much more to this method in the coming videos, but for now, let's say return. And we'll want to redirect to current Umbraco page. So this means that when a form has been submitted, the user will be redirected to the same page, the one with the form. Currently, we're doing nothing with the data coming from the form submission, but don't worry, we'll get to that in just a bit. First, we need to update our article form partial view. So let's open that again up here. Okay, what we need to do here is we need to replace the static HTML tags here with something that will actually work with our controller. For that, we'll be using an Umbraco helper method. So we'll say using, and in the parentheses here, html.beginUmbracoForm. So this helper takes two parameters. The first one being the name of the method we'll be using upon form submission, which was submit. And the second parameter is the name of the controller, so article form, but leave out the controller part of the name. All right. Finally, we need to start the curly brackets here and close them again below the form. So down here. There we go. All right, now our form here will work with our controller and vice versa. Now, before wrapping up this video, we need to render our article form partial view here on our form template. And now that we have our render method in our controller, we can actually achieve this. So let's jump into our form template up here. In here, we will once again use an HTML helper. This one is called action. This will take two parameters. The first one is the name of the method we want to use, which in this case is render. And then we add the name of our partial view, which is article form. All right, and that's it. We should now be able to build our project. And once we fire it up, we will see that our form is now rendered on our form submission page. First though, let's go ahead and add a little breakpoint to our controller in here, just so we can see that it's actually working. So I'll add one right here. All right, so let's go ahead and try this out. We'll run the IIS Express here. The project will build. And we're up and running. All right, let's see what happens when we try to access the submission page here. Great, we have our form rendered here with all the correct fields and labels. Now, let's try to fill in some data as well. So, name of the article here, a summary. Let's skip the image for now. Some article contents. This is an article. All right. Author name. Let's just give it my name and title. Documentarian. All right. Let's see what happens when we click submit. All right. So we can see it hits our breakpoint here. And if we see down here, and if we open the model, you can see that it also receives all the values that I filled into the form. Now, this is the data that we want to work with. We want to take all of this data here, the data coming from the form submission, and use it to create new articles on our website, new content pages. For now, this was it for this video, and we have now created our first surface controller, which not only lets us render out our partial view, but we're also using it for our form submissions. We're not doing anything with the data from the form submissions yet, but in the next video, we'll start to work with the data and use it to create new content on our website.